Okay, so we are at the second part of this lesson, and now we are going to continue from the previous video where we stopped at how to know the size of our eyepiece reticule scale, the length of our scale. To know that, we need to calibrate our eyepiece reticule using the stage micrometer. So in our previous video, we got to calculate what is the length of our stage micrometer. Using that scale, we are going to calibrate our unknown scale, that is the ocular or the eyepiece micrometer. Once we do that, then we can use that scale to measure the size of any microscopic specimen that we want to observe. So again, reminding you of the setup, we have the 10x ocular lens or the eyepiece lens. Then we have the 4x objective lens focused on our specimen. So the total magnification in which we are going to view our specimen is 40 times. Let's see how our field of view will look. Field of view means when you put your eye focused on the eyepiece lens, what will you see? So right now on your stage, you have kept the stage micrometer, which looks like this. And you are now going to see something like this. In your eyepiece already, your eyepiece reticule is there, which is this one. Look at the arrow. Your eyepiece reticule scale is visible because it's in your eyepiece lens. You have kept the stage micrometer on the stage. So because of that, you can see the stage micrometer scale also. So you can see two scales now. You can see the stage micrometer scale. You can see the eyepiece reticule scale. This is at 40x. Now you know the length of this scale, but you don't know the length of this scale. So the best way to do that is by superimposition. What is the meaning of superimposition? All of us have handled microscopes before. You know that using the microscope, keeping your eye on the eyepiece, you can move your slide. So the red arrow shows the direction in which you're going to move your stage micrometer on the stage. So you will remove the clips and you will slowly keep, do not move your eye from your eyepiece. You will slide your stage micrometer to the left. So that means your hand will move to the right. Always remember, because you see inverted images in the microscope. So when you move your hand to the right, your eye will see, to your eye it will appear as if the scale is moving to the left. So you're going to slide the stage micrometer scale, and this way it will look like this, slid to the extreme left. And why did I do that? Because I want to superimpose the stage micrometers. I want to superimpose the stage micrometer 0 with the eyepiece reticule's 0 mark, so that at least the starting divisions will lie correspondingly coincided to each other. Okay, this I have to adjust. After I align the zeros of both the scale, then my job is to find which is the other division which is completely aligning with, I'm going to find another division on this scale and another division on this scale apart from the zeros, which will coincide just like the zeros are coinciding. Here is what I mean. This is another scale, not the same as the previous slide. So here superimposition has been done. Look, the zeros are exactly positioned upon each other. This is the eyepiece scale and this is the stage micrometer scale. After you perfectly superimpose, which needs some time, with practice you can superimpose very quickly. So here the superimposition is done in such a manner that the zero of the eyepiece is completely coinciding with the zero of the stage micrometer, and the next division that I'm seeing is completely coinciding, I would say is 100 of the eyepiece reticule. It's coinciding with the 95 of the stage micrometer. Now the thing is, in our previous video, we had already calculated the length of the stage micrometer. So if I know the length of the stage micrometer, can I now calculate how much is the value of these 100 divisions of the eyepiece graticule? Yes, I can. Provided, remember, when you change the magnification, that is, when you change the objective lens of your microscope, this lens, you will have to calibrate again. So when you change the objective, the size of the stage micrometer keeps on changing. So when the stage micrometer size keeps magnifying or shrinking, every time you change the objective lens, you'll have to recalibrate your eyepiece graticule. So basically, calibration means eyepiece graticule divisions are unknown units. We want to find out, basing on the stage micrometer length, what is the eyepiece graticule scale. Okay. So in the next video, I'm going to show you that at 40x, how can we calibrate our eyepiece graticule.